Welcome to the Buddy Show. Alex with the weekly news. Gio with the weekly sports. Juan with the internet questions. Make sure to tune in weekly to the Buddy Show. And now, Julio, Alex, Gio, and Juan.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back. We made it to the fourth week in a row. I can't believe it. And we have Gio back with us. What's up, Gio?
I'm back in line.
Back in action. It's good to have you back, man. We missed you.
Yeah. I saw you guys questions on Fernando, and I was like, I was just laughing at it, though.
You were laughing at what we were asking Fernando. It was fun. We had a fun time with Fernando. He answered the questions very interesting.
I know.
That's another thing it reminded me of.
I know when he said something about Juan's what was it? Juan's Xbox.
Oh, that's right.
PlayStation.
What about you, Juan? What's up, Juan?
You had it been Fernando, my boy, or what?
It was the first time he went live with us in the show.
Oh, I know, I thought that. I was laughing at it, though, when you said it.
That was a lot of fun to have him on here. Thank you guys so much for joining us again. It's been a lot of fun so far. We've been having a lot of fun. Right, guys?
Yes, we have.
We can't wait to keep doing these, so let's get right into it.
Curious.
So my wife calls me one day to tell me that our son had asked her if he was adopted. And she right away responded, "Of course not. Where'd you get that idea from?" And our son showed her a DNA test that read that they were no match for relatives in our family, but strong matches for a family who lived down the other side of the street. And she called me in a hurry, and she says, "Honey, Fred, he got a DNA test. And I don't know how to say this to you, but he may not be our son."
Damn.
And I said, "Well, obviously." And she said, "What do you mean? It was your idea in the first place," I told her. "You remember the first night in the hospital when the baby did nothing but scream and cry and cry and scream on and on and on, and you asked me to change him? Well, I picked a good one. I'm proud of you, Fred." Okay, these are ways that people met their girl. I met my girl at a magic show. She vanished that week. I met my girl in jail. I had to lock her down. Yeah, I worked there. I met my girl at a grocery store. She was checking me out. I met my girl at a donor association. She stole my heart.
Okay, today in pop news, we have a really interesting story. Marylin Monroe would have been 95 this week. She would have been 95 years old. I don't think guys would have been looking at her the same way they did in the 1950s and the 1960s when she was on covers of magazines and all that stuff. She's 95. She's going to be an old lady, right?
Wow.
95. She was an actress from the 1950s and the 1960s. And around that time, I mean, I wasn't alive, but from what they told me, a lot of stuff wasn't allowed, like, to show legs on the girls, you know, when they wear dresses. And she was one to bring that up and say, hey, I could dress however I want. Doesn't matter, right? What do you guys think of that?
That's, I think, what is right going on with this?
What happened?
Right now that you mentioned that, I think I heard, I seen movies, because I have a Disney Plus, and I think I seen movies that she had a maid, but I don't remember right now the actual name.
That she had a maid?
She had a maid. I heard that she had a maid movie.
Oh, like, that she made movies. I thought you meant she had a maid, like a sirvienta. Oh, like, maybe she had enough money to have servants.
I mean,
how and talking about maybe, Disney Plus, yeah, once you have that money, Juan, you're right. Disney Plus came out with a new movie called Cruella. Have you guys seen this new movie?
Nope.
So you had to pay for it, which is kind of like the downfall. Like, just like the other Disney Plus movie that came out was called Raya. That one, Raya, I really wanted to watch. It's like an animation of a superhero, but they charge, so I just wait. I just wait till it comes out for free.
When is it?
It comes out later on this month. I think the 15th, you're going to be able to watch that one for free. And
that's nice, though.
Also, it must be nice. Well, you don't have Disney Plus? You should get Disney Plus.
Nah. Only on the regular TV, but on the other TV I have in my room.
Oh, well, you can watch it on your sala TV. O dile que te dé el password. Amá, dame el password.
I know.
All right, guys. In pop news as well, we have 6 countries with incentives for people who are ready to retire. So if you're ready to retire, which I don't think I am, but there's countries that give you certain advantages or discounts, and I'm going to talk about a few of them right now. So in Italy, you can buy a home for €1. I don't know how much €1 is, but
like
it sounds really cheap. Sounds
like I'll say like $200.
You think like €1 is like $200? I don't think €1 is $200, but I'm sure those houses are all beat up.
Julio, I had a question right there. What is euro?
Euro is a form of money that Europeans use. So we use dollars here in the US, and they use euros. So compared to the dollar, I don't think it's that much of a big difference.
Oh, okay.
In Panama, you can have a lot of discounts for foreigners that go and retire there. In Greece, the tax rate is 7%, which is super low compared to here, like in the US or other states like this, where it's 10% all the way to 37%. They take taxes, obviously, for different programs, different things that the state is doing, right? And in Greece, because you're a foreigner, they tell you, come retire here and we won't charge you that much taxes. So that's a cool thing about retiring in Greece. In Malaysia, they offer you a way to live there but continue working from the US. So that's pretty cool. You can live somewhere where you don't have to spend so much of your pension, right? Because you're trying to retire. It also, Portugal offers 2-year visas for people who are retiring. And then the Philippines, I heard, is really beautiful. They have universal health care, and they have a exempt for a foreign tax on your pension, so they're not going to take any of that money that you bring over from the States. So those are some places that I look forward to retiring. How cool would it be to live on a beach somewhere or in Greece?
Yep. Now that you mentioned that, the Philippines, I had a teacher that she used to live in the Philippines, and she's just really, really nice. Like,
yeah,
the houses
I've
and
heard
everything.
too. I had a friend in music school who said his dad was a cop. He is from the Philippines, and he said his dad was a cop, and it was a very intense. I can imagine as a cop in another country, it's got to be really tough, right? A lot of intense stories, I think.
Time for
internet questions.
Questions. One of the internet questions that I have for you guys today is, do you ever not take breaks when you're doing labor work because it makes you lose momentum?
So we're gonna do this a little bit backwards today, all right, Gio? So don't worry. And me, honestly, I can't take breaks when I'm trying to do something laborious or that I'm a sweat a lot. I can't, because I feel like I'm a stop and I'm not gonna want to continue. What about you guys?
Probably not really, dude.
You like taking breaks?
Not
when
really.
You're doing
I
heavy
just
work?
Nah. Probably I need a break from all the heavy works.
Oh, okay.
Daily.
That's good. You get tired? Why do you get tired?
It's because it's heavy and it will fall.
Ah, there you go. That makes sense.
You guys want to know something funny or something
what?
Cool? When I was back in work, when I was in high school.
Yeah.
So I went to work and I was helping the store, and I was like carrying heavy stuff like juices. But the happy thing was I didn't make it drop because I know how to pick it up.
Oh, so you held on to it just right before it fell?
Yep.
Oh,
because I was like right in the corner, those boxes.
Yeah.
So I was like,
you gotta push yourself, because if you take a break right there.
Yeah, so I was like right in the corner on the edge. And I was like, no, you know what? You know what? I was like, let's get this one.
What about you, Juan? Do you ever take breaks when you so you won't lose momentum?
Like,
or do you?
It depends. Like, if I really want to increase my goal faster, I won't take breaks. But if there's like a big case that I really need to take a break, then I will take like a 10 to 20 minute break.
Oh, okay.
And continue
Makes
doing
sense.
My task, what I'm doing.
That's cool. What about the other question that you have for us?
Oh, and the other question was, how did you get out of being lazy? What was your motivation?
Gio, what was your motivation out of getting lazy?
Harley. that was like me cleaning Oli, though. To get myself
cleaning?
Lazy.
Okay, what motivates you to clean?
I don't know. Probably the room.
Probably when you see it dirty, right? You're like, oh man, I gotta clean it. I don't know about this.
Yeah.
Or in the case when your parents say, if you si hacen el quehacer, le doy $10.
There you go. That's another incentive. That's good.
Nah,
money,
I
think, always incentive.
I don't return money. I just receive food. And that's it.
Just feed me. Just give me some tacos. I'll be good.
Yeah, just give me some food and I'm good, dude.
Thank you, Juan. Thank you, Juan, for your questions.
Let's get ready to rumble!
My name is Gio, and I came to talk about sports. So, one of people today at sports, it's a basketball game. Today, the Lakers play the sixth game for the NBA playoff. And then, also, they have a new game on Xbox. Need for Speed. And I just came to talk about you guys about shoes. Nike shoes are $80. And clothes are, like I told you guys, and there's like $160 on Vegas.
That's a lot of money.
Yes, sir. But that's for people who are live over in Vegas. I don't know how they do it, though.
Buying clothes. Buying all that expensive clothes. Yeah. You're right,
including with jewelry, though. Jewelry is expensive.
Jewelry is expensive. All right, guys. Right now, we're going to try to invite our special guest, okay? Let's see if he answers.
I wonder who it is.
His name is Sideshow. And last week, just so you guys know, last week I butchered the name. I was so sad. There's no space in Sideshow. It's all together, okay?
I'm thinking about it. Who is it? Who is this person?
You're going to see. He's an artist. He recently came out with an album, so we're going to share his music while he's answering some of our questions. You guys can ask him, like, what his musical preferences are, what he grew up listening to. Let's see if he answers. This is going to be fun.
Yes, sir. Let's see. Let's go.
Meanwhile, he connects. I have would-you-rather questions for you guys.
Let's see. Rather question.
Yes. Would you rather, Gio, would you rather have an Xbox? Or have an Xbox, PlayStation 5, computer, a PC, gaming computer, or a Switch? And the rest gotta go.
Really? All right. Right now, I have an Xbox, so I just choose the Xbox.
Yeah? You would stay with the Xbox?
Yeah, I choose my little baby Xbox.
Oh, that one's good. So you got the digital one, the one where you don't have to put CDs in.
Yes, sir.
I call it a
baby boy.
The baby boy? What about you, sir?
For a rather question, like I said in the other episode, it was like the PSI is like my child.
I don't know. So you were saying the PS5.
I will stay with the PS5.
Oh, how fun.
No, what? I kind of switched the name of the Xbox, so.
You switched it to what?
A new name, but on that one's gonna be, I call it a princess.
You gave it. I think I'm with Gio. I would stay with the Xbox and get rid of everything else.
The PS5 is like they said in another episode, too. It's like a beauty having a PS5.
It is. You're right. It does look like a spaceship. That's the cool thing about the PlayStation.
Yeah.
And the last would you rather question I wanted to ask you guys. Hopefully Joey can join us before we end the episode. Would you rather be a dog, a cat, or a shark?
I'll say shark.
Why would you rather be a shark?
I don't want to live in the water.
That's a good question.
You just want to swim, Gio.
Yep.
Gio, did you used to swim back in the day?
Nope.
No? You know how to swim?
Nope.
No? Hey, you got to practice if you want to be a shark.
When I was little, it's cool swimming, but I never went to the water.
You were like, not for me.
Nah.
I want to be a shark. Where I am.
Yep, I want to be a shark to be here.
Juan, what about you? What would you choose?
Since I have a pet and it's a cat, I'd rather to keep him company, I'd rather be a cat.
Ah, very good. So you'd rather keep someone company?
Yeah.
I think that's. So that's what I would be. I don't think I would want to be. Hey, Joey, there he is. What's up, Sideshow?
Can you guys hear me?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
How are you?
I'm great. Good to have you.
We're over here answering some funny questions. And guys, I think I'd want to be a dog. Dogs, I think, have it easy. You just give them some food. They'll be good. And they follow you around. They protect you. I think I'd want to be a dog instead of a shark, Gio.
I know. I prefer the shark though.
You prefer a shark? Yeah, you prefer the hunt.
Yep.
That's right. Joey Sideshow, aka Sideshow, here with us.
Yo.
Thank you so much.
Let's go.
For being here with us.
Thank you guys.
This was planned from a while ago. I've been wanting to have Sideshow on here. So just to clarify, Sideshow, can you spell how you spell Sideshow?
It's PsydeShow.
There you go. So there's no space. Okay, guys?
No space.
I butchered it so bad last week. I tried my best.
You're good.
All right, Joey. So the first question I wanted to ask you, Sideshow, is what are your musical preferences?
Oh, I'm all over the map, man. I literally, if I threw my Spotify playlists on shuffle, it would just explode. It would have no idea what to do. I go from random. Recently I've been getting more into my punk rock stuff, okay. Earlier days. I absolutely love punk rock. I grew up on that. My later years, I got into metal and all the surrounding genres that came with that. And then while I was younger too, I was exposed to hip hop. I was always around hip hop, but it was really I want to say after high school that I really, really got deep into hip hop. And that's what sort of once I found that there's all kinds of things that you can do within the genre, that it's not confined to any one sort of sound. I just ran with it. I love it.
And you took it, and you can hear it throughout the whole album. It's very well organized as well.
Thank you.
What are some of your favorite artists?
I've got a Slipknot tattoo right here. That's always going to be. I've got another one, Korn on my foot, another album cover of theirs. And that's absolutely my preferences. New metal, stuff like that. Very the heavier, cool. Anything yeah, with Linkin Park. Bounce. Yeah, Linkin Park, absolutely. Chester is one of the main inspirations for how I use my screams. So,
cool. Do you guys have any questions for him?
Do you have any motivation music?
If you can kind of look at it as motivational, a lot of my stuff is just it's me working through my own issues. So a lot of it is depressing. A lot of it is angry. A lot of it is just it's angsty. You know what I mean? It's just a lot of angry music just because I'm working through a lot of issues and stuff right now. But, it is what it is. There's an underlying tone of but I'm getting through it at the end of the day. So that's sort of where I'm at with that.
That's awesome. Oh, wow. What about you, Gio?
Who's your favorite singer though?
I bounce between that. It's always going to be Corey Taylor from Slipknot. He's massive inspirational, vocal inspiration to me. But honestly, singing though, I was saying Chester from Linkin Park, Chester Bennington for sure is a massive influence on the melodies that I kind of come up with. They're raw and they kind of go with the beat itself. And so that I'm listening back into old Hybrid Theory and Meteora, those early Linkin Park records, and I'm noticing, and I'm oh wow, that is exactly where I got that from.
To reminisce on that or to catch that, or certain melodies that you maybe play on an instrument or sing a certain way, and then you catch where you catch it from. That's the coolest feeling, because you're like, oh, that's a connect. Yeah, that made a connection in me so deep that, you know, I had to express myself that way as well.
Absolutely.
I have so much fun listening to your music, Joey. And Juan had a couple questions for you.
Oh, absolutely.
All right. One of the questions people are asking is, do you ever not take breaks when you're doing labor work because it makes you lose momentum?
You're meaning like in the music, like taking breaths?
Or just in general, I think.
Or in general, like in your life or in music.
Got you. Well, I mean, I'm a lead at my job right now, so like that's pretty much just my 9 to 5. You know, that's what makes the money. That's what pays the bills, you know what I mean? But I mean, honestly, I try and find like breaks from that wherever I can, and where I do find that is being creative, you know. Like I'll come back straight from work and I'll lay down a track that I've been like thinking about all day at work, and I'm just like listening to on my phone in my car, and like it's coming back and it's really getting to do that. That's where I feel like that's where I feel like I'm alive the most. You know, I feel like I'm thriving in that moment.
Exactly.
Oh.
So yeah, the work is there. It's going to be there. You know, it's necessary to make the money, unfortunately, in the society we live in. But I, you know, I'm out here doing what I do, you know, what I love to do.
Exactly.
That's what defines me.
The important part.
Yep.
That you have your definition of what makes you, you know, and absolutely. Also, SideShow, talk a little bit about your fashion. I know right now you couldn't have all your digs on, but usually you have spiked up mohawk, yeah, like the whole look. If you guys notice, I don't know if you guys noticed, but he paints his nails, so he goes all out when he performs too. You guys should definitely check out his music. Thank you, Joey, so much for being with us today, man.
Thank you, man.
Make sure you listen to his album, All Is Unwell. It's available on Spotify, Apple Music, all that good stuff. Thank you guys so much. Joey, see you next time, man.
Have a good one, man. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Bye, Joey.
Man, that was so cool. Thank you, guys. Thank you. That's all the time we have left. My name is Julio.
My name is Gio.
My name is Juan, and stay tuned for the next Buddy Show. And don't forget to check out the social media on Facebook, Instagram, and other social platforms like
all that
Spotify.
Stuff. Thank you guys so much. You guys did awesome. See you guys next time.
See you again. See you again.